Good afternoon, Standard 9 students. Now, yesterday I had taught you, discussed the lady, the type of a person she was, okay, and she left behind 3 children. What was her image or respect for how she was treated by the village people? But then, after her death, they forgot all her past, and then now they are looking forward to bury her, and they brought in some clothes suitable for the funeral and some food for the starving children. And altogether she had left behind 3 children. There were 3 of them. Of these, now we are being introduced to her children. Okay. John, the oldest, a boy of 12 years, was a stout lad, means he was a strong boy, able to earn his living with any farmer, means he was stout enough or he was strong enough to help any farmers in the field. Kate, between 10 and 11, was bright, active girl, out of whom something clever might be made, if in good hands. Okay, she was a bright, active girl, and if anyone who knew how to handle her, then they would have made or converted her into a very good human being. But poor little Maggie, the youngest, was hopelessly diseased. 2 years before, a fall from a window had injured her spine, and she had not been able to leave her bed since, except when lifted in the arms of her mother. So now the third child, Maggie, she was a diseased child. 2 years back, she had fallen from a window and she injured her spinal cord, and for that reason, she was not able to get off from the bed. So whenever she had to get off the bed, she had to be carried or lifted up. And that work was actually being done by her mother. So now we have been introduced to this lady, about this lady, and when she was alive, what was her living conditions, how she was hated, and then the village people, how they sympathized after she died, and then we were introduced to her children. So now we know the children well. Okay. What is to be done with the children? The mother is dead and gone. Now, what has to be done? That was the chief question now. Everyone was concerned. Now, since the mother is dead and gone, what will happen to her children? The dead mother would go underground, means the dead mother would be buried and be forever beyond all care of concern of the villagers. Once she is buried, now what's happening with the villagers, what is going to happen to her children? Now she is beyond all concern, because now she is no more, she is dead. But the children must not be left to starve, whatever it may be. But the children should not be left alone to starve, because maybe their mother, somehow she would try to manage to arrange some food for them. But now she is gone. After considering the matter and talking it over with his wife, Farmer Jones said that he would take John and do well by him. Okay. Now they were three children. Now we know John was 12 years old. He's 12 years old and he is quite a stout boy, strong enough to help people in the farms. So Farmer Jones, before he could take or make his decision, he had consulted his wife and informed her that this is what has happened in this particular village. And there is a stout boy, 12 years old, who could be a big help, who could help me in the farm. Shall we take him over? Shall we adopt him? Now they were not adopting John because he lost his mother. They were adopting John because John could be a great help to them in the field. Then his wife also felt that we are getting a helper free of cost and who would be a great help to her husband in the fields. So she gave the green signal that we can take over John. Okay. Now the problem, John's problem has been, Farmer Jones' problem has been solved, and even John, now he will be living with the Jones family, so his living condition will be better than the condition that he is living now. Now that his mother was out of the way. Now perhaps everyone knows that this is a poor family. Maybe many of them wanted these children to work in their house as servants so that they could earn some money, get some food to eat. But the mother, although she was very, very poor, she was an alcoholic, she was a fighter, she was very quarrelsome. Nobody liked her. But she never allowed anyone to take advantage of her financial condition. And she never allowed anyone, she would fight if anyone even proposed her. Why don't you allow your big daughter to come and work in my house as a servant girl? So since the mother was out of the way, now it was very easy for Farmer Jones to take over John. Now like Farmer Jones, there was another lady, and Mrs. Ellis, who had been looking out for a bound girl, who was looking out for a servant girl, concluded that it would be charitable in her to make choice for Katie. Another name for Kate was Katie, even though she was too young to be of much use for several years. Okay. Now, when people go to see or to attend a funeral or go to see the dead body in a person's house, there are many people who have got different ways of looking at things. Some are opportunists, some only come for gossiping, some will only, you know, see what is taking place, who's doing what, who is crying the most, who is not crying, and all that. So there are people who attend, who come for no reason, and they come to see if they could take advantage of the situation. Okay. Now comes the role of Mrs. Ellis. She was looking out for a servant girl, but she cannot say that I will take over this girl and make her work for my house. So she had to put it across to people in a very diplomatic way. So she says, since nobody has the inclination or intention of taking Kathy, I think I should take her over. Though she is an undisciplined child, though she is of no use to me, but I will tolerate it. I will see what best I can do with her. So on the basis of showing her sympathy, but the underlying motive is based on that she wanted a servant girl. Farmer Jones wanted a helper in his farm. So they are opportunists. They are taking full advantage of the situation and they are playing with people's sentiments. Okay. Now, Farmer Jones took the boy not because he felt sorry that the boy lost his mother. Okay. And he will be starving. But he looked at it that this boy can be helpful to me. So I shall take over it, give him a room, give him some food, but whole day I will make him work hard in my farm. But in the eyes of the people, Farmer Jones was considered to be a very nice man. See how good this gentleman is. At the time of need, he is now taking over the big boy. What a gem of a person. Like that, even Mrs. Ellis was praised for showing her concern and being very kind and very generous. But none of them failed to see the underlying motive. Mrs. Ellis was not such a kind-hearted person to take over an orphan child. She was desperate for a maidservant. She says, though this girl is very young, but actually that's the kind of a person she needed to do all her household chores. And that is why she says, since nobody is taking over this girl, I think I shall take her on the basis of charity. Though I have to put up with her, means though I have to tolerate her, I may have to, tolerate all the nonsense because she's an undisciplined, very stubborn child. But I will bear it up. I will take care of it. So, on those grounds, Mrs. Ellis took over Kathy. Now the question rises about Maggie. So in the next class, we will discuss about Maggie. Okay. So I shall be, today I will not be sending you any notes, any question and answers, because I've already sent you the internal assessment matter. So please write it down. From tomorrow onwards, I shall be sending you the question and answers of this particular chapter. Okay. Thank you.